my choir, of course. Beach, Virginia.
Hi, everyone.
Everyone, this is Crackers, a blue and gold recall. And assisting Crackers this afternoon is Katrina. Katrina is from right here in Tampa, Florida.
Hello, everyone. Crackers, that was a nice wave. Can you do it again? Good job.
How about a big round of applause for our beautiful recall?
See, a mouthful of sun conjures.
Ah, sun contours.
No, sun conjures. They're small parrots from South America.
South America, huh? They've had quite a flight. I bet their little wings are just exhausted.
No, I mean the species is from South America. Many sun conjures like these guys are found in cities all around the world, and they make very popular household pets.
Really?
Yeah.
Do any of you folks out there have any sun conjures as pets?
Conjures.
Oh, right. Anyone have any of those birds or any birds as pets?
Yeah. Well, you know how much work it takes to keep these beautiful birds happy and healthy.
How about a big round of applause for Robin and her sun conjures reputations because of their eating habits? They like to eat lots of dead animals. Uh-oh. Looks like Kia may be on the hunt for some food right now. I suggest all of you in the audience look alive.
Unless someone would like to come down here and play dead for Kia.
Oh, that reminds me of a joke I heard once.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. There were these two vultures eating this dead comedian, right? And so one vulture turns to the other one and says, "Hey, does this guy taste funny to you?"
You're the crickets, Tim?
Yeah.
He never said it was a good joke. You see, vultures are kind of like nature's janitors. Sometimes they'll eat so much that if they get startled, they'll need to regurgitate to quickly lighten their load before they can take flight.
Katrina, when you say regurgitate, you mean...
Oh, yeah.
Tell you what, folks, let's do our best not to startle Kia as she exits the stage. Yeah, all right. I suppose I got an extra dollar for you here somewhere. Robin, do you have an extra dollar bill?
No, sorry.
This is really embarrassing. Does anyone in the audience have an extra dollar bill? Anyone out there? Way up there. Okay, buddy. You grab your dollar bill and come down to the railing. What's your name?
He's playing the right hand all the number if you can see it. Did you see that money? Go get it. Okay, go ahead and hand Phoebe the money. Lucky, zipping through that second hoop in the middle of the theater, up and around through that third hoop on the right. Then she's gonna fly back to me.
Yeah, I don't think she can do it.
Of course she can.
I'll bet you a dollar she can.
You're on, Tim. Come on, Phoebe, let's show how you do it. Audience, are you ready? Let's try that again. Are you ready?
Because they are excellent hunters, and they help control the rodent population around many farms and gardens. And they adapt readily to man-made nesting boxes like the one to my right over there.
Wow, Tim, that was quite impressive.
Hey, thanks, Katrina.
But tell me, how did you know all that?
Well, to tell you the truth, it's in the script.
Yeah. I see. What? Now this silent flight is possible because owl feathers are very soft and have
claw-like projections that act as mufflers.
Would you cut that out?
Sorry, just trying to appear as wise as an owl.
I see.
Hey, you know they say that glasses make people look smarter.
Sometimes.
Oh, yeah. Well, tell me, what do you think now? Huh?
Yeah. Not this time.
No.
No. I think you've given me a great way to move on to our next owl. His surrounding real wise. These feathered spectacles make her look very intelligent. Unlike some people. Owls like Mia are also called knocking owls because their call sounds like a woodpecker knocking on a hollow log.
A knocking owl? Hey, everyone, help me out. Knock, knock. Wow, Gomez can really move when he wants to, huh?
can achieve running speeds of up to 25 miles per hour. They also have a very unique way of preparing their food. Would you like to see what I mean?
Yeah.
You don't sound too sure. Would you like to see what I mean?
Yeah.
That's better. In case you haven't noticed, it is an audience participation show. Let's find some Gomez would like to eat.
Okay, what are we looking for? Like
something exciting?
Mole cricket or...
Well, what do you have in your hand?
Oh, this is my pet lizard. His name's Murphy.
Wow, can I see him?
Yeah, sure.
Ooh.
Right away from
me. Wow, he's adorable.
Yeah, he is, huh?
Say goodbye.
No.
You see, since Cereal's beaks and feet aren't very strong, we need to kill their prey by beating it on the ground. Pretty cool, huh, Tim?
That's not so cool.
Now, this technique is also given to Cereal with the nickname Lizard Smasher. Imagine that. Hey, Gamez, how about one more slam dunk? Make it count. Gomez here, back to his home. Now these birds are unique because unlike most birds, they hunt like a wolf pack.
You mean they hunt moose? It's funny, they don't look that big.
No, Tim. They use the team approach for finding and capturing their prey. Some of the group will flush out the prey. Once the prey is on the run, the dominant harris hawk will capture it.
Oh!
Well, I hope he shares.
Well, yes, harris hawks, unlike most birds of prey, are quite social. They share the hunt, share the dinner, and sometimes even share the same perch.
Oh, so they eat fish, too.
No, Tim, not that kind of perch. I mean a high point, such as a tree branch or a cactus top to rest on while searching for food.
If there's a lack of suitable perches, the hawks will just stack one on top of another.
Really?
And truly.
Hey, what is the scientific term for such unusual behavior?
Stacking.
Oh, well, you can't argue with that logic.
It looks like they might be trying to flush you out.
Smothering
it. If it were prey, it would already be dead.
Huh.
What Killy's doing is a behavior called mantling.
He's mantling.
You don't know what that is, do you?
No idea, but...
You did a pretty good imitation.
Yeah, I was hoping this baby looks smart.
Exactly the opposite. He's hiding his meal from other predators in the area.
Oh, you mean like when you're having lunch and I walk in and you quickly do this?
Yeah, exactly like that.
Mantling, that's a
fun. 4,000 years. When the sport moved to Europe, it got the nickname the Sport of King.
Oh, Killy.
This is the HR Yellowknife Amazon, native to the Amazon rainforest. Is that right? Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Yellowknife Amazon have the amazing capability to mimic human speech, especially Lolita.
Your favorite song. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a morning.
I've got this beautiful feeling. Well, I'm sure that's something you'd like to say to the audience before you go, so go ahead and say it.
Bye.
Say it again.
Is a bachelor eagle.
Oh, he's a bachelor, huh? I'll have to hook him up with some chicks I know.
No, Tim, it's not bachelor, it's bachelure. This is French for balancer, or a tightrope walker. They get this name because they can't, which means they lean from side to side in flight.
Yeah, well, what if they can't?
Bachelors can't. It's rare they can't.
I'm trying to say that five times really fast.
Covering over 200 miles.
Wow, talk about your frequent flyer.
In fact, these birds are so often seen in the air, many African tribes believe that they never come to the ground. Now, this is incorrect, as bachelors commonly feed on carrion. But what do you know, Tim? Dead animals.
Yes, which, of course, are found on the ground.
Of course.
Ladies and gentlemen, meet Sanibel, a bald eagle, the national symbol of the United States of America.
Sanibel is an adolescent bald eagle who is only 4 years old. Her head and tail will not be completely white until the age of five. The bald eagle was chosen to represent our country over 200 years ago. At that time, they were quite common in many states, but today eagles like Sanibel have become a rarer sight.
What happened?
Well, there were a variety of things, but some of the most devastating were the widespread use of pesticides and the loss of their natural habitat. The good news is the federal government has recognized these problems and has enacted laws to protect these and other birds of prey.
Folks, we all need to work together to see that these conditions continue to improve. These magnificent birds and all of the beautiful creatures that you can see today at Busch Gardens are a part of nature. Now we all share in this beauty and therefore have the responsibility to take care of the environment. We have seen some great birds today, and I for one would like to see them again. How about you guys? You want to see our friends one more time?